Part 1. An electric pendulum is placed between the vertical armatures of a plane capacitor charged under a voltage of absolute value UAB equal 10 power 4 volts. Like this, we have here two armatures A and B. And we have a pendulum that's formed of a string and a small ball. Part 1.1, the charge Q is negative. What is the sign of UAB? Now here we have the plate B attracts the negative charge Q. So B is positively charged and A has a negative charge. So the answer is the plate B attracts the ball which is negatively charged. So the sign of B is positive and A has a negative charge. So UAB is negative. UAB equal minus 10 power 4 volt. UAB negative since the first pole is negative. Remark. We have here UAB equal minus 10 power 4 volt. The sign of voltage, take the sign of the first pole. We have here A negative, so the voltage is negative. But here we have the first pole is positive, so the sign of voltage is positive. Now, part 1.2 gives the characteristics of the electric field vector E between A and B, such that the distance between them is D equal 10 centimeter. So, for the characteristics of E, we have the origin, any point of plate B. Since the plate B is a positive armature. We say here any point of plate B. Since every line, every field line has its proper origin. For this line we have this origin, for this line we have this origin. Now for the line of action of E is perpendicular to the plates. We have here E perpendicular to the plate A and to the plate B. Or we can say that E is horizontal. Now for the direction. E is always oriented from the positive armature to the negative armature. So B is oriented from B to A. For the value of E, we have E equal U over D, the voltage of over the distance. And we use here the absolute value of the voltage. So 10 power 4 over the distance that is 10 centimeter, that's equal to 0.1 meter. So we obtain E equal 10 power 5 volt per meter. Now, for the part 1.3, the charge Q is minus 20 nanocoulomb, and its mass is M equal 1 gram. Name the forces acting on the charge Q and determine the value of the angle alpha at equilibrium, given G equal 10 meter per second square. Now for the forces acting on the ball, we have the tension of the string T here, the electric force F here, since the charge is negative, so F is opposite to E. Now we have also the weight of the ball, W vector here. That's always vertical downward. Now, to calculate the value of F, the angle between the string and the vertical, we have at equilibrium the sum of force equal to zero. So T plus F plus W, we have here W equal to zero. So projection along x prime x, for that we take a system of axes x prime x, y prime y, like this. Now projection along x prime x, so for t we have t cosine, the angle between x and t, pi over 2 plus alpha, here. Plus f cosine, the angle between x and f, we have f and x prime x have the same direction, so the angle between them is 0. Plus w cosine of 3 pi over 2 or minus pi over 2 equal to 0. But cosine pi over 2 plus alpha is equal to minus sine alpha. Cosine of 0 is 1, so we have plus f. cosine over 3 pi over 2 equal to 0. So obtain this relation, t sine alpha equal f, the first equation. Now, projection along y prime y, we have t sine pi over 2 plus alpha plus f sine 0, sine 0 is 0, plus w sine 3 pi over 2. Sine 3 pi over 2 is minus 1. Sine pi over 2 plus alpha is cosine alpha. So we obtain this equation, equation 2, t cosine alpha equal w. Now, we divide the equation 1 over the equation 2, 1 over 2. We obtain t sine alpha over t cosine alpha equal f over w. We simplify by t, and here we have tangent alpha, sine over cosine, tangent alpha equal f over w. With f equal absolute value q times e, that's equal 20 times 10 power minus 9. Since q is 20 nanocoulomb, 10 power minus 9, times 10^5 the value of e. So f equal 2 times 10 power minus 3 nu. And w, the weight, equal m times g. But the mass is 1 gram. So equal 10 power minus 3 kilogram times 10 equal 10 power minus 2 newton. So tangent alpha equal 2 times 10 power minus 3 over 10 minus 2 equal 0.2. We obtain alpha equal tangent minus 1, 0.2 equal 11.3 degree. Now for the part 2. Consider the three points E, F, and G between the plates here. With E, F is horizontal and F, G is vertical. The distances between these points are E, F equals 7 cm and F, G equals 4 cm. Part 1, find the voltages U, E, F, and U, F, G. We have U, E, F, according to the general formula of voltage between the plate of capacitor, we have U, E, F equal E vector, scalar product, E, F vector. That's equal to the value of E times the distance between E and F times cosine of the angle between E and E, F. But here, E, F and E are opposite. So the angle between them is 180, that's equal minus 1. Here we have E equal 10 power 5, the distance EF is 7 cm, that's equal 0.07 meter times minus 1. So UEF equal minus 7000 volts. Now for the voltage UFG, UFG equal E vector scalar product FG vector, that's equal the value of E times the distance FG times cosine the angle between FG and E. But here we have FG and E are perpendicular. So the angle between them is 90 degree. Cosine of 90 degree is 0. So UFG equals 0 volt. For the part 2, deduce the value of the voltage UEG. Here, UEG. Now, according to the law of addition of voltages, we have UEG equal UEF plus UFG. UEF is minus 7000 plus UFG is 0, so UEG equal minus 7000 volts. And the last question is, the charge Q is minus 20 nano. Part 3, a charged particle Q equal 10 power minus 9 coulomb moves from E to F. Find in this case the work done by the electric force acting on this particle during this or its motion. We have the work of the electric force when the charge moves from E to F equal to Q times the voltage UEF, that's equal 10 power minus 9 times minus 7000. So the work of this force is minus 7 times 10 power minus 6 joule.